Good morning. Welcome to St. Aloysius. Please rise, turn to each other, and welcome one another. And let us join together in singing number 185, Jesus is Risen, number 185.
Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, the companionship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Amen. My sisters and brothers, we gather together this morning in great joy on this second Sunday of Easter. We gather together in joy on this Divine Mercy Sunday. We come together as a parish family, visitors, welcome. Those of our parish family and visitors online, welcome. It is good for us to be able to pray together this morning. We know that in this Easter season, we carry with us our own baptism, our own sacraments of initiation. We brought multiple numbers in, 12 people last Saturday. I'll talk about that in the homily a bit. But at the beginning of each Mass, we ask for God's mercy. We ask for greater trust in God's love, especially on this Divine Mercy Sunday. And remembering that we are baptized into that love, let us together make our prayer as we remember our baptisms through the sprinkling rite.
I saw water flowing from the temple, from its right hand side, alleluia. And all to whom this water came were saved and shall say, alleluia, alleluia.
And all
May Almighty God cleanse us of our sins, and through the celebration of this Eucharist, make us worthy to share at the table of his kingdom. Amen. Let us pray. Thank you. God of everlasting mercy, who in the very recurrence of the Paschal feast kindle the faith of the people you have made your own, increase the graces you have bestowed, that all may grasp and rightly understand in what font they have been washed, by whose spirit they have been reborn, by whose blood they have been redeemed. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. The community of believers was of one heart and mind, and no one claimed that any of his possessions were his own, but they had everything in common. With great power, the apostles bore witness to the resurrection of the Lord Jesus, and great favor was accorded them all. There was no needy person among them, for those who owned property or houses would sell them, bring the proceeds of the sale, and put them at the feet of the apostles, and they were distributed to each according to need. The word of the Lord.
Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His love is everlasting. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His love is everlasting. Let the house of Israel say, his mercy endures forever. Let the house of Aaron say, his mercy endures forever. Let those who fear the Lord say, his mercy endures forever. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His love is everlasting. I was hard-pressed and was falling, but the Lord helped me. My strength and my courage is the Lord, and he has been my Savior. The joyful shout of victory in the tents of the just. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His love is everlasting. The stone which the builders rejected has become the cornerstone. By the Lord has this been done. It is wonderful in our eyes. This is the day the Lord has made. Let us be glad and rejoice in it. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His love is everlasting.
A reading from the first letter of Saint John. Beloved, everyone who believes that Jesus is the Christ is begotten by God, and everyone who loves the Father loves also the one begotten by him. In this way, we know that we love the children of God when we love God and obey his commandments. For the love of God is this, that we keep his commandments, and his commandments are not burdensome, for whoever is begotten by God conquers the world. And the victory that conquers the world is our faith, who indeed is the victor over the world. For the one who believes that Jesus is the Son of God, this is the one who came through water and blood, Jesus Christ, not by water alone, but by water and blood. The Spirit is the one that testifies, and the Spirit is truth. The word of the Lord.
see me, says the Lord. Blessed are those who have not seen me, but still believe.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. On the evening of that first day of the week, when the doors were locked where the disciples were for fear of the Jews, Jesus came and stood in their midst and said to them, "Peace be with you." When he had said this, he showed them his hands and his side. The disciples rejoiced when they saw the Lord. Jesus said to them again, "Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, so I send you." And when he had said this, he breathed on them and said to them, "Receive the Holy Spirit. Whose sins you forgive are forgiven them, and whose sins you retain are retained." Thomas, called Didymus, one of the 12, was not with them when Jesus came. So the other disciples said to him, "We have seen the Lord." But he said to them, "Unless I see the mark of the nails in his hands and put my finger into the nail marks and put my hand into his side, I will not believe." Now a week later, the disciples were again inside, and Thomas was with them. Jesus came, although the doors were locked, and stood in their midst and said, "Peace be with you." Then he said to Thomas, "Put your finger here and see my hands, and bring your hand and put it into my side. Do not be unbelieving, but believe." Thomas answered and said to him, "My Lord and my God." Jesus said to him, "Have you come to believe because you have seen me? Blessed are those who have not seen and have believed." Now, Jesus did many other signs in the presence of his disciples that are not written in this book. But these are written that you may come to believe that Jesus is the Christ, the Son of God, and that through this belief you may have life in his name. The Gospel of the Lord. So 1 week ago, we were jammed in here on Easter Sunday, full of joy, celebrating. 1 week ago yesterday, Holy Saturday, a week ago, we used this baptismal font that's still up in this octave of Easter. This baptismal font for five of our parishioners, five of our elect, and a total of 12 people on Holy Saturday that were confirmed and received into full communion. So five were baptized, a total of 12 confirmed and received full communion. That's a journey. That's a journey of faith, and we are all on it, and it isn't only a journey that happens when we are baptized or when we are confirmed. It's a journey that's ongoing throughout our lives. It's a journey that we see in a telescoped way in the gospel today. To get to a place of faith, to get to a place of belief. We are baptized and confirmed into God's divine mercy. And we celebrate that, and we watch as we witness the disciples and the interaction between Jesus and them in these two scenes in the upper room. You know, this 20th chapter of John, it's a very rich chapter. We heard the beginning of it last week. The discovery of the empty tomb, Peter and John, after Mary Magdalene has gone back to them and said, the tomb is empty and we do not know where they have taken the Lord. And so they run, and we heard the gospel last week. We know that one. And then that beautiful, beautiful scene, the exchange between Mary Magdalene and Jesus, when after Peter and John have gone and she's still there in the garden and she doesn't know that it's Jesus and thinks that he's a gardener and asks him, do you know where they've taken him? I mean, you can feel her distraught and confused, representing all of the disciples and what they would have been feeling, and Jesus speaking her name. And then she understands. Then she recognizes him. It's a very poignant scene, full of human emotion. And now again, Jesus appearing in the upper room, the disciples locked behind doors, struggling to understand and make sense of what's happened. They saw, they know the crucifixion. They have heard the report of the empty tomb. What does it mean? They're afraid. That's why they're behind locked doors. And Jesus' words to them are, peace be with you. Three times we heard it in this gospel, peace be with you. It's a greeting of encouragement for them to have faith, to have a peace of heart that lets go of their fear, because in the gospels, consistently, the opposite of faith, it's not agnosticism, it's not atheism, it's fear, which you could argue is a form of atheism or agnosticism. It's a worry and an anxiety that erodes our trust in God. And so we can, in our fear, see, we have to take matters into our own hands because God's not going to get it done. Peace be with you, Jesus is telling them as they sit in that very spot, that internal space of fear. Peace be with you. And then he shows them, this was real. See my hands, see my side. And they rejoice. Now that's a telescoped journey right there. They go from this place of fear and confusion, yet maybe hoping, with the empty tomb, but not yet understanding, to rejoicing. That's the journey of faith we all have to make. And it takes a lifetime. When Jesus shows them his hands and his side, as they rejoice, I think the rejoicing is not a sense of, oh my goodness, the horror of the cross wasn't real. Jesus is alive. I don't think that's it for them. Because Jesus is showing his hands and his side to them. No, it was real. The horror of the cross was real, yet he is raised. In reality, he's raised. As a child, the sisters used to teach us that our sins contribute to the crucifixion of Jesus. Now, I kind of had a hard time getting there. My biggest sins were probably taking cookies that I shouldn't have been taking out of my mother's stash. And I didn't quite see, even as a kid, I didn't quite see, okay, how does that measure up to putting Jesus on the cross? It doesn't. Because it's too direct, it's too one-to-one, it's too simplistic. But as an adult, looking at how sin works in our world, social sin, the ravages of war, economic injustice, human rights violations, the abuse of the environment, and so much more, That does make sense, that it contributes to the crucifixion, that our sins matter. It's all complicated. We know that. We know it's complicated to not cooperate, and there's not simplistic answers, but it calls us to be people of justice. It calls us to remember to be people of peace, and the it is in the background of God's love and mercy that we're celebrating today. Jesus then missions them and gives them this greeting of peace again. I'm sending you. Have courage. Have strength of heart. Have faith. Have joy. Receive the Holy Spirit and go out and forgive sins. Our God of mercy is sending the apostles out, the disciples out on a mission to forgive sins. Whatever sins you forgive are forgiven. Whatever you retain are retained. I have to tell you, years of hearing confessions and being in spiritual conversations, as we heard in our readings today, as we heard in the psalm, God's love is everlasting. God's mercy is everlasting. I don't think God retains any of our sins. So the only sins that would be retained are the ones we hang on to. Exercising our own free will and holding back for all sorts of reasons, usually because they shouldn't be forgiven. I wouldn't forgive them. I don't deserve it. Well, I've said to you before, you can dismiss that one pretty quickly. No one deserves this kind of love. It's an abundant love that none of us can earn. But we are called to receive, to accept this generous love that God continues to extend to us. An abundant love. And so, sins that are retained are the ones unconfessed. I think it's an encouragement. This Divine Mercy Sunday is an encouragement. Thomas is a little hard-headed here. Sorry, St. Thomas. I won't believe it until I can see it. He wants proof. And then he gets it. This isn't a huge obstacle for Jesus. Thomas, he's been with these guys. He's been with this group of disciples following Jesus around for 3 years. They know each other. And they tell him an experience they've had. Jesus is risen, and he says, I won't believe it until I can see it. I won't believe you. I don't trust you. People he knows. I underscore that because I think it shows the frame of mind, the frame of heart that Thomas was in, that they all were in. And sometimes we can be there too. Jesus, no problem. I'll show up for you, Thomas. See my hands. Touch them. See the wound in my side. It's real. The cross was real. Resurrection is real. So we celebrate divine mercy. We celebrate a journey of faith. Last Saturday night, our catechumens went on a journey of faith around the church. Beautiful gesture. Made a pilgrimage to this font as the whole congregation, we were singing the litany of the saints, praying for the communion of the saints to join us as we prayed for our elect, making their journey to the baptismal font. And then from there, we all make a journey from the baptismal font as followers of Jesus, called to trust in God's love, called to trust in God's mercy. Called to let go of the things we hang on to. Sometimes we can. Now, I know some of you are aware of Disney princesses and maybe have even seen Frozen. And I think there's a song in Frozen about letting go. That's what I've been told, at least. Okay? Well, it may have something to say to us about what is retained and what isn't. Let it go. That's Jesus' invitation to us always. And as John says in the second reading from his first letter, this is the victory of faith that conquers the world, trusting in God's love that has no limits, no boundaries, no bottom, no end. John in his gospel concludes this chapter and reminds us all on our journey from the baptismal font into our lives. The things that John writes in the gospel, they're not all the things that Jesus said and did. They're not all that Jesus did after he was resurrected. But John tells us, these things are written, the ones that I've written, are written that you may come to believe that Jesus is the Christ, the Son of God, and that through this belief, we may have life in his name. And so, my sisters and brothers, let's stand. And as a people of faith, as a people on a faith journey from the baptismal font, let us profess that faith as we renew our own baptismal promises. Do you renounce sin so as to live in the freedom of the children of God? I do. Do you renounce the lure of evil so that sin may have no mastery over you? I do. Do you renounce Satan, the author and prince of sin? I do. Do you believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth? I do. Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, suffered death and was buried, rose again from the dead, and is seated at the right hand of the Father? I do. Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting? I do. This is our faith. We are proud to profess it. As a community of faith, let's bring our prayers to the Lord.
For the Church, may she continue to be transformed through the encounter with the living Christ, and be an instrument of healing and forgiveness in the world. We pray to the Lord. For all the newly baptized, may they continue to grow in the Christian life and be patient with themselves as they begin this new part of their faith journey. We pray to the Lord. For the grace to forgive, that the Spirit of God's divine mercy will help us to forgive as God has forgiven us, and give us the strength to be instruments of forgiveness in our families and communities. We pray to the Lord. For the gift of the Spirit upon the world, that God will breathe the Spirit of divine mercy upon all peoples and structures, so that the dignity of each person is upheld. We pray to the Lord. For all who struggle with doubts and fear, may Jesus Christ calm their fears and touch their hearts with peace. We pray to the Lord. For renewed stewardship of God's creation, may God guide us to effectively care for creation and preserve its beauty and resources for the coming generations. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. God of all creation, we bring before you all our prayers. As you hear them and answer them, continue to deepen our trust in your love. We make our prayers to you always in the name of Jesus Christ, our risen Lord. Amen.
Let us sing number 533, Peace I Leave With You, number 533.
Peace I leave with you. Your hearts be troubled, peace be with you, peace I leave with you, my peace I give to you, let not your hearts be troubled, peace be with you. Do not let your hearts be troubled. Have faith in God and faith in me. Peace I leave with you, my peace I give to you. Let not your hearts be troubled. Peace be with you.
Pray, my sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. Accept, O Lord, we pray, the oblations of your people and of those you have brought to new birth, that renewed by the confession of your name and by baptism, we may attain the unending happiness through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord. But on this day above all, to laud you yet more gloriously when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying, he has destroyed death, and by rising, restored life. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise. And even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory, as they acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and the working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and the blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when the supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, And as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and the blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Aloysius Gonzaga, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and the salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Thomas, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him, with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At Jesus' command, formed by his teaching, we dare to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles as they were locked in an upper room, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen." May the peace of the Lord be with you always. Amen. Let's offer each other a sign of Christ's peace. Thank you. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold the one who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are we called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say your word and my soul shall be healed.
Hallelujah.
Number 475, eye has not seen. Number 475.
Give us the mind of Jesus.
Let us pray. Almighty God, grant that our reception of this Paschal sacrament may have a continuing effect in our minds and hearts through Christ our Lord. Amen. Okay, perfect. Two announcements, just two, very quick. One, there are children's books that are there for the taking that are by the doors called Magnificat, and they're a prayer aid and a teaching aid for parents. Second, there are coffee and donuts today downstairs in O'Malley Hall. My sisters and brothers, the Lord be with you. Bow your heads and pray for God's blessing. And please respond with a hearty amen at the end of each of these blessing verses. May God, who by the resurrection of his only begotten Son was pleased to confer on you the gift of redemption and of adoption, give you gladness by his blessing. Amen. May he, by whose redeeming work you have received the gift of everlasting freedom, make you heirs to an eternal inheritance. Amen. And may you, who have already risen with Christ in baptism through faith, by living in a right manner on this earth, be united with him in the homeland of heaven. Amen. And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down upon you and remain with you forever. Go in peace. The Mass is ended. Alleluia, alleluia.
Thanks be to God, alleluia, alleluia.
And let us join once more in singing number 572, Festival Canticle, Worthy is Christ. Verses 1, 4, and 5.